ultimately people are conscious beings. They also have emotions like us. They also have aspirations like us. And ultimately they also want joy and want to avoid distress. So essentially they're similar to us. It's just that they may have some different conceptions philosophically. The compassionate vision sees people as conscious beings, not as philosophical categories. This is indicated in the Bhagavad-Gita 6.32, where Krishna says, Atma upam yena sarvatra samam pasyati yo Arjuna sukham va yadiva dukham sayogi paramo mataha. It says, Atma upam yena sarvatra, that by comparing with the self, samam pasyati yo Arjuna, one sees all living beings equally. Sukham va yadiva dukham. That we see that actually everybody in their happiness and distress are similar. Everybody longs for happiness, everybody wants to avoid distress, and everybody, based on their knowledge, is doing what they can to do these two things, to gain happiness and avoid distress. Now, rather than reducing them to their philosophical conceptions, we see beyond their philosophical conceptions to their essential aspirations. And we try to connect with them at that level. So reducing people to their philosophical categories will alienate them. But connecting with them at the level of their essential aspirations will help us to develop a human bond. And sometimes a human bond expressed through culture and civilized behavior, politeness, courtesy, can connect people and help them to overcome whatever philosophical misconceptions that they may have. So if we can see people as conscious beings, just like us essentially, and connect with them, then we can elevate their philosophical understanding so that it harmonizes with the nature of reality. And then they can fulfill their essential aspirations for happiness in their spiritual identity and in their spiritual connectivity with the all-attractive Supreme, Krishna. Thank you. Hare Krishna.